Hi, this is Ali and you are watching the ChatGPT Features video series on Learn Awesome. In this video, we shall discuss how to use ChatGPT effectively and maximize the output of your ChatGPT session. You can think of ChatGPT as the most knowledgeable and well-read person you are interacting with, except that you need to be fully aware that it's not a human. It's a model or algorithm with limitations, some of which we discussed in previous video, and it has little to no common sense. To get the most out of interacting with a very knowledgeable person, or to extract the desired or right answers from them, you need to come up with the right questions. As an example, you can ask ChatGPT about an airplane, and it might start telling you about history of airplanes from Wright Brothers' time, while you were expecting it to tell you about types of airplanes based on their engine type or fighter jets. In this case, it's not the fault of ChatGPT. The question itself was ambiguous. This is true for any topic you can think of. Having multidimensional knowledge about most topics, ChatGPT can go on a complete tangent to your expected answer if you're not specific enough. So framing the right question is absolutely essential. A model maps the words used in the prompt to an output. The more detailed your question is, the more ammunition it has to prioritize the response as per your needs. Feel free to add as much detail to your questions as you like. Though the interaction may feel like you're talking to someone, the other side is a model, so shamelessly instructed about the kind of response you're looking for. Each word you use would help or guide you towards a more appropriate answer by taking guesswork out of the equation. You must have used Google before and received millions of results as an answer. Though Google ranks them well for you using its PageRank algorithm, you still need to provide further filtering to limit the variety of results being presented. You use site filters to restrict results from specific website. If they're searching for a specific person, say an actor, you can add certain keywords like celebrity to narrow down the research results and remove people with the same name from results. You can use all of these techniques to disambiguate your answer with ChatGPT by adding filtering statements or commands in your prompt. Do you get annoyed when someone starts telling you a very basic answer which you obviously know about while you were expecting something more intelligent? You can land in the same situation with ChatGPT. It does not know you, and most obvious answer is perhaps the most common, say frequent answer online. In unsupervised learning, frequency of occurrence has a direct say in prioritization of a content used in response to related questions. There are a couple of ways to get around the problem. One is to note that ChatGPT uses your conversation history as a context for further communication. So if you already told ChatGPT your favorite fruit, color, car, or that you are a graduate student, and then you ask a follow-up question, the answer would take that existing information about you into account. Secondly, you can explicitly tell it to treat you as an intelligent person skilled in this and that. Yes, you really can. And see the response change. The converse is also true if ChatGPT is throwing you a PhD-level response and you feel a English please moment. Try asking it the same question after telling it to respond like it's talking to a kid, and then telling it to respond like it's talking to a professor, and see the answers change. By the way, ChatGPT does not understand sarcasm well, so English please wouldn't have the desired effect, but you can try. You can ask it to level up with you though by repeating questions with instructions that answer should be such and such level. This video series is called ChatGPT Features, but why are we discussing features? The purpose is to be aware of what ChatGPT is capable of, and how to maximize the outcome of your interactions. As you go along, you will learn plenty of techniques to make your communication more effective and get more with less. Please consider to like and subscribe if you like the video. See you in the next one. Thank you and goodbye.